If you're looking to buy Madden 22 coins, head over to MMOEXP.com for the fastest, cheapest, and safest coins on the market. Click the link down in the description and be sure to use code THRONE for 5% off and upgrade your team today. All right, guys, welcome back to my second channel. Today we have a Mutt gameplay versus one great user. This is while I was recording my JC Jackson and CD Lamb gameplay, and right when I match up with user, I do the same for when I match up with other pros or especially streamers, and especially if they're live, I really don't like uploading to YouTube the game. I don't like uploading other games versus streamers unless I kind of have to or I'm desperate for content. And to be quite honest, kind of desperate for content right now, especially after I lost my file of the final five games of my weekend league. With me traveling home, I got put in a pretty huge bind to be able to keep daily uploads going. So thankfully we have this game. It's an awesome game between me and user. And he is 3-0 against me heading into this game. I want to be as transparent as possible. You haven't seen any of the other three games. He has beaten me three times this year, okay? So just keep that in mind. I'm not trying to act like this is the first time we're matching up or anything. No, he's been my freaking dad this year. All right, he's running that 2-4-5 odd. He typically plays pretty good defense against me, and especially good defense out of or against bunch tight end. He does a really good job keeping me in the pocket and getting pressures. We're seeing Reggie Nelson screaming off the edge. I was pretty worried about moving the ball heading into this game. User's definitely a good defensive Madden player. So we're gonna try a few different things. I tried blocking my running back sometimes. I tried blocking my tight end, a couple different IDs, and to be honest, just kind of getting screamed at. So I start getting a little bit worried. We might need to go to some other form. So why not send out five out of bunch right here? We're on a 3rd and 14. Wheel route, Kyle Pitts. Able to make it a 4th and manageable. And this is damn embarrassing. The second time user has baited me with this zone. Okay, I just want you guys to watch this play and let me know if you would have thrown this. And I can talk about it here more in a sec after it. Oh man, I think it's a shaded down vert hook. That thing gets so baity, and to be honest, he didn't even play really good defense. He gave me both flats. My running back flat was open, my out route was open on a 4th and 1, and I throw with the vert hook. I get baited. That's the second time this year I think I chucked the hitch out of flood at a hook that baited me the exact same way. It played the flat and jumped back up. He loves those. I'm assuming it's a shaded down vert hook with no zone drop. He loves those, and they get real baity. So it's something that either I need to implement more or just be more careful of, especially when I'm playing good players, because that caught me incredibly off guard. Here we go, 2nd and 4. I'm throwing another ball into coverage. Thankfully, that's why we throw to the sideline right there also. You know, it's an extra defender, it's an extra offensive player. People like to talk about it as an extra defender. No, it's an extra offensive player. They're not going to catch picks. Okay, if you throw it to the sideline, they're just going to catch one out of bounds. Thankfully, right here, we have our flat, little route bounce up with Bo. Kind of a bit of a struggle drive so far. We've thrown two really bad balls. One was a 4th down, but we've thrown a couple bad balls, and we've been in a 3rd down and a 4th down. Pretty rough so far. Hopefully, we can turn things around. I'm going to go to curl flat again. We got screamed at last time I did this. Thankfully, we pick it up. We have all day. It's a touchdown, 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 and we're marching into the end zone. All right. I'm happy with 7 there. I'm thankful for 7. I'm lucky to have 7. Okay. Can't ask for much more after a drive as bad as that than to be up a possession. So I wanted to say one more thing. Yeah, no, again, this gameplay, at the time I matched up with him, I just recorded the gameplay just for myself because I like watching back games versus good players. He's going to go to verticals, and he must have thought this is a deep blue. Not pretty questionable. It was a really bad read. And, of course, I get lucky, and I catch my pick when I threw 2 the previous drive and didn't get punished for either of them. I actually got rewarded for one of them. I picked up a 4th down, throwing right at him. And what do you know? He makes a bad read, and we have 7 off it. So we are up 14-0 to start the game. And I did mention this ends up being, this is a really good game. This is a really, really good Madden game. Against a good player, too. That's a rough start for user, but user's tough. Really good pocket right here on verticals to be able to step out. You could have scrambled, but recognizes he's able to kind of get outside my contains and throw the crosser. Just butt naked. Right here, nice little Texas route. That's something I want to do more. I kind of like 4 verticals of the Texas route. I'm not 100% sure about how good the spacing is, but I want to do it out of PA boot over or out of verticals more. Start running. I might run a backfield master. That Texas route is so good. And especially, I struggle to beat man. Texas routes beat man really, really well. I think that would be a... I think they would help me out a lot. As here's second and two. I'm going to man out of Watt. No, I'm in zone now. And he's going to have both. I was going to say he has both wheels, but he throws a little hitch there. And it's a touchdown. I guess the tight end wheel was covered, but... And just like that, 7-point game. So we're back on offense. And I have mentioned... and the first drive showed it. I have struggled against him in terms of moving the ball. I have been given a hard time. So here I am going for a super, freaking super steamer supreme. I get sacked again. This Reggie Nelson is screaming at me. I was going for a super deep cross route of Trey White Flex. I've been trying to mix that play in more. I don't know how good it is, but I think it's good. It's worth running once or twice a game. And thankfully, I think we're gonna pick it up. Yay! We finally picked up the pressure. We're gonna get a laser to Cliff Branch. Oh, we picked up the pressure. It's about damn time. Can we figure something out? Now I'm in milk territory. Milky, milky, milky. And I decide, nah, I'm not gonna milk. It's fine. I even snapped this before the 2-minute warning. I'm pretty sure. I think I go to boot over with a curl, right? I snap this, don't I? Oh, I'm pretty sure I snap it. I do snap it. Yes. I'm dropping back, and I'm bagged, so we throw away. Thankfully, we had a receiver near the sideline. I was going to milk it originally, and then he's also streaming. I think milking is, like, super, super, super sweaty, and I don't want to make, I don't know, I just don't want to be at my world's most sweaty when I'm playing someone who's streaming, because I hate it when people do the same to me, so... And not that milking's like really, really bad in this situation, but I tried to pass and not really waste too much time. It's right here, like, I have a touchdown, so I take it. And we're already up a possession too, so like worst case scenario, he can score 7 here with little time left, get the ball back and score 7. And I'm in a tie game in the absolute worst case scenario now with ball in the second half. That's still in the driver's seat, so taking 7 is not the worst thing either, but regardless, I didn't milk him. He's going for this super bomb. He's running clear out. The play's really, really good. It was the Skimbo bomb from earlier in the year. So he calls a lot of 4 verticals. Calls some clear out. And I think he goes back to clear out here on 3rd and 9. And I man it up, by the way. I'm pretty sure. Nope, he goes to verticals. And my vert hook doesn't get there. I'm pretty sure. No, I don't think. I think I shaded that. It might be this play that I made it up. Yeah, so it's... No, it's not. I'm just stupid. But we're screaming at him. He goes to Bunch Trail. He has a touchdown. Touchdown. We scream at him. My pass rush did get after him on a few plays. This is the play. I man up the slot. So I'm like, he's probably going to clear out. This should defend it. And no, Derwin gets cooked by Moss. Thankfully, we're able to make him work for points. I guess being on the 6-yard line with one timeout in this situation isn't the easiest. But pretty sure. Yeah, it's pretty lucky, actually. I forgot how he scored until I saw the play being snapped. I was like, oh, yeah, this is going to get thrown right at my soul. And but he gets 7, so going to be up 7 at half with his ball. So need to D up. 11 seconds left. Not sure if I go for a strong slot bomb just trying to catch him off guard. I was like, you know what? Maybe he will think I'm running the ball, but really I'm trying to just nuke him. And no, I get sacked. I don't love calling timeouts in that situation. I probably shouldn't have. Like, I'm not going to score on him here. Like, I'm not playing a freaking moron. He's just going to run back with his user. His name is One Great User. You'd have to have a real shitty user to not use the bomb with 5 seconds left in the half. But regardless... Should have just taken it to half. There was no reason for me to call timeout there. And here we are. I'm starting to run some cover 3 cloud now. Now that I'm just like, oh, I'm kind of sick of having to defend all these plays against cover. Which, by the way, that is... I almost think he's throwing it too early. Maybe he can throw that. It definitely beats cover 3. But I don't know if he can throw it at the time he threw it. I think he needs a little bit more time. Now we're squealing, by the way. Now we're getting after it. John Abraham is getting after him. That's Johnny football. Okay, I was going to say, cover 2, I just had so many... There's so many bombs in Bunch for it. You can go to Bunch Trail. You can go to 4 verticals. You can go to clear out. Running cover 2 against Bunch. If you don't get pressure, you are getting nuked. And right there he had Omaha. I wish my younger brother would have kept a little bit more in on the edit. I was changing my defense like crazy. to try to get him to keep audibling and use all his audibles and maybe be in the wrong play. I was switching between match and cover two, and then like I like randomly was inside thirding my safety and stuff because he had Omaha, so he was like staring at my play art. And thankfully we end up getting some pressure and coming up with a sack. My guys were fighting for me. Is that horrible stick? I need to do something better there, right? Like I've got a spin or like why am I trying to truck? Anyway, he's in goal line. He's got man coverage on Brandon Marshall. Guess what? I have red zone threat. He's got a star. Touchdown, 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 dunk. And we'll take our seven. And that's where I don't know if I can get rid of red zone threat. It's so good for a one gotcha a game. Like, especially if you need a big two-point conversion, you're pretty certain they're in man and you haven't done it yet. You can gotcha them so easily. Like, there's my free two-point. Like, it's... I love red zone threat. One AP... I could probably be using elsewhere. I mean, that could be my backfield master if I chose to go get Roger Craig. But I've been rocking red zone threat, even with B Marsh coming off the bench still. I have red zone threat on him. So again, up 14. His ball, so much time left in this game. Six and a half, or four and a half, five and a half minutes left. Wow. Yeah, 4 minute quarters, Taylor. 4 minute quarters, you idiot. And I didn't see what I changed my zone drops to. Flats 15. I'm assuming I'm just calling cover three cloud then. As I'm searching for the play, because I never call cover three cloud. I really just call, I call DB fire basically every play out of dollar. He's flipping short side. I'm assuming this is going to be bunch trail, right? Yerp. He's going for the nuke. I'm back there with Cam and Cunningham. Still able to get yards. This dude Cunningham. It's crazy when he came out. Little bits of me thought I would stay with Josh Allen. Like little bits of me. Crazy that that was ever something that was in my mind, that Josh Allen would could possibly be the best quarterback after Randall Cunningham came out. Granted, I figured it out very quickly into using Cunningham. He was the best, but man, that mobility. The dude's crazy. Speaking of crazy mobility, if you play against Boomer Esiason with he had both the crosser and the wheel route, by the way, right there. If you play against Boomer Esiason with Pass It Elite and Escape Artist, that dude's nutty. That dude's cracked. That guy's a terrifying dude. He might be the best QB in the game, actually. It's him or Cunningham. I don't think you can really argue for anyone else. Maybe if you're a Marino user. Yeah, definitely Marino could be. But not for me. I don't like Marino. I don't like Pass It Elite. Give me my gunslinger. Give me my slinger. And the good thing is we're... Well, I was going to say we're making him work for yards, but he did throw a deep crosser out of four verticals. But we had good defense on the first down. Just need to hold him to three. Holding three is crucial. We squeal at him. We got Ed Reed flying off the edge. I mean, this is just a shit show, by the way. And I don't really care, to be honest. I am about to drive to a freaking hotel next to the airport and wake up at 5 a.m. and go fly back to Texas, okay? That's what I'm about to do. And it's nighttime already. Like, I just need to get this video out, to be quite transparent. I need to get this video out. Oh, man. No redos. One take. No cuts. Give me my rock. Where's the fumble? Fourth and 11. Oh, this play is just brutal, man. We D the hell up, too. We D the hell up. Please tell me I blitzed my user. I'm pretty sure I do. Yeah. Yeah, I got my user blitzed. Oh, and we do shed. He just makes a play with Cunningham. He just makes a play. He was bagged. He just made it. He made a great play. Hats off to him. That's a true broken play mastermind type of play. That's a hell of a play from user. And the 3 yard line. 3 yard line is really hard to stop people. And yeah, he's going back. He's going down the single back wing pair, so he's not going to be in bunch. Just smart. I pretty much recommend to everybody you be in under center inside the 4 or 5. I don't know why so many people insist on running bunch at this yard line. I think under center is a lot better. We are going to blow it up. Now, granted, there is a run commit glitch, but run committing is not that great. Especially if you have an RPO. Run commit glitch doesn't work against the RPOs. It's right there. Thankfully, we're able to hold him on the inch line, though. I feel... Do I get him to a fourth down here? No. Yeah, no, I don't. Yeah, just the easiest touchdown. Ty Law gave good effort, though. And just like that, back up to being only up 7. 2:34 left. We really just need, and he used a timeout. Oh, he used the timeout on the fourth down when he had Omaha. He used a timeout and then ran another play. It wasn't in the video, but that was when he called his first timeout. So pretty rough situation for him here. One play, it's going to go to the two-minute warning. And then he only has two timeouts. So even if I was to run the ball three times and punt, it's not looking pretty for him. He'd be in a minute and a half with no timeouts. No, I'm stupid. No, I'm dumb. I can't do that. Regardless, it would still go to the two-minute warning. Yeah, it would just be like, it would be like 143 or something like that. Hell, he should probably call timeouts before the two-minute warning then, which I do recommend. But I call the deep cross right to try. Yeah, no, my brain is mush, by the way. It's, I don't know what I'm saying. I call the deep cross to play out of Trey Y flex. I get screamed at again when I have it open. Please let me throw it. Give me a half second. I got Reggie Nelson just flying off the edge at me. This dude has been miserable all game. He's just been eating my ass off the left side, off my blind side. Going to the two. So, we need a dot. Second and 16. Just need to make this manageable. I don't know what I go to. Not a clue. But we need to make it manageable. If we get to a third and seven, would be great. Oh, am I going for a nuke? Oh, I'm going for a nuke! Is he going to contain, though? I'm motioning over the slant. Good. Distract the user a little bit. Distract the user and throw the nuke. Touchdown. And we go down. That's going to be GG's. He does end up quitting out right there. Guys, I appreciate you watching this video. And thanks for sticking with me through all the no face cam videos. Ideally, I'm going to have a face cam video out tomorrow on both channels, on my main and my second, from Texas. Granted, I'm going to be exhausted. It's going to be after my flight, but... I'm really excited to be back at my setup and we'll probably have games 1 through 5 of Weekend League tomorrow here, and I'll figure out the main channel upload when the time comes, but I appreciate you guys watching. I'll see you in the next one.